Hello everyone, this is Rupesh. Today I'll be engaging a different topic, that is heterocyclic chemistry part 2 in unit C401 OC organometallic and heterocyclic chemistry. In heterocyclic chemistry part 2, today I'll be discussing 7 and large member heterocycles, that is to be specific 7 and 8 member heterocycles. Before going to the 7-member heterocycles, the purpose of studying chemistry of heterocycles is just because of the wide applications in the medicinal and drug synthesis. That is, we can see and we studied in the earlier classes that the most of the drugs and medicinal organic chemistry, most of the drugs are made up of an heterocyclic atom, heterocycles. So the purpose of studying is a wide application in the medicinal organic chemistry as well as in the pharma industries. Now let's see 7-membered heterocycles. 7-membered heterocyclic rings containing one heteroatom are the heterocyclic analogous of 1,3,5-cycloheptatriene. That is, it is a similar structure as that of 1,3,5-cycloheptatriene with single heteroatom. Sometimes it consists of more than one heteroatom. Heteroatoms are oxygen, nitrogen, and sulfur. These heteroatoms are nonpolar. It is proved by X-ray crystallography, and hence it behaves as a polyenes. That is, it consists of more than one double bond. Though they don't comply with, that is, they don't satisfy the Huckel's rule of 4n plus 2 pi electrons and are thus non-aromatic in nature and possesses a high reactivity. Here, we'll be discussing oxypin, thiopin and azepin, which are the parent compounds of the 7-membered heterocycles with one heteroatom. This is the general structure of an 7-membered heteroatom, 7-membered heterocycle with one heteroatom. If X is replaced by oxygen, then it is called as oxypin. If X is S, then it is thiopin. If X is NH, then it is called as azepin. Now let's see one by one. Coming to oxypin, monocyclic oxypins exist in equilibrium with bicyclic isomeric benzene oxide, that is 1,2-epoxybenzene. This is the structure of oxypin. And you can see the oxypin is in equilibrium with the 1,2-epoxybenzene. That is, the double bond will be shifting here to form an epoxide ring, and this bond shifts here and this bond shifts here. So these two structures will be in equilibrium. For this reason, the bond parameters for oxygen and other monocyclic derivatives, which are very difficult and have not been determined yet. The spectroscopic data show that oxypins have a polyolefinic structure with localized carbon-carbon double bonds. Oxypins exist in a non-planar boat conformation that equilibrates with inversion as shown. This is the boat conformation which will be equilibrium. This will be the inverted non-planar boat conformation. But this process is slowed down by fusion with benzene rings. That is, this process is slowed down by reacting with the substituted aromatic rings. Here is the example where you can see all the double bonds are reacted with the aromatic rings. Coming to the synthesis of oxypin, let's start from the benzene. Epoxidation of diverbenzene with metachloroperbenzoic acid and subsequent photolysis or pyrolysis of the epoxides gives the parent oxypin. There is a diwar benzene which on epoxidation by using metachlorobenzoic acid we get an epoxide. This on photolysis, that is shifting of a sigma bond to form a pi bond, we get oxapen. Now synthesis of oxapen using from 1,4-cyclohexadiene. This is 1,4-cyclohexadiene on reaction with per acid, we get an epoxide. Epoxide on bromination, we get an dibromo compound. This on, that is, this is called 1,2-epoxy-4,5-dibromocyclohexane, which on reaction with sodium methoxide, we get an epoxide, that is 1,2-epoxy-benzene. This sodium methoxide is a base which abstracts a proton which is present here to form a double bond, and Br is eliminated. And one more equivalent of sodium methoxide which abstracts a proton which is present here to form a double bond, and the bromide is eliminated. This 1,2-epoxybenzene which is equilibrium with oxapen. Coming to the synthesis of oxapen using valence bond isomerization, that is 1,2-divinyl ethylene carbonate on pyrolysis in the presence of lithium chloride gives divinyl ethylene oxide, which rearranges to give 4,5-dihydroxapen. This is 1,2-divinyl ethylene carbonate. This on decarboxylation using lithium chloride, we get divinyl ethylene oxide. This rearranges to give 4,5-dihydroxapen. Reactions of oxapen, that is, applications of oxapen. Reaction with acid. Oxapen undergoes fissile, thermal or acid catalyzed rearrangement to give phenol. Here 4-methyl oxapen, that is 1,2,3,4, 4-methyl oxapen on thermal or acid catalyzed rearrangement, we get a substituted phenol, that is paramethyl phenol, that is paracresol. Coming to the mechanism, there is this double bond, the rearrangement happens here, this double bond attacks here with the shift of this double bond, and this double bond shifts here to form an epoxide. This epoxide abstracts a proton from an acid, and the bond which neutralizes an oxonium ion to form an alcohol. The solution, this proton loses itself to form a double bond, to form an aromatic ring, to form cresol. Diels-Alder reaction. Oxapen reacts with maleic anhydride to give the corresponding adduct. That is, oxapen which is in equilibrium with 1,2-epoxybenzene, which undergoes reaction with maleic anhydride to give an adduct. Photochemical reaction. Oxapen undergo ring contraction to give bicyclic compounds. That is, oxapen on radiation, we get a 5-member ring which is fused to 4-member ring. That is, ring has been contracted from 7 to 5, which is fused to 4. Coming to the next heterocyclic compound, thiapen. This is the structure of the thiapen. The parent compound has not yet been synthesized. Most attempted synthesis of thiapen give benzene derivatives. However, highly substituted derivatives have been obtained in a stable form. Coming to synthesis of thiapen, 2,3,4,5-tetramethyl thiophene reacts with diacetylene in the presence of Lewis acid to give thiophene derivatives. This is highly substituted thiophene on reaction with diacetylene in the presence of Lewis acid, we get an thiophene attached to a four-member ring, that is cyclobutane ring, which on rearrangement we get an fully substituted thiophene, that is highly substituted thiophene, which is a stable one. Coming to the next synthesis, cis hexatriene reacts with sulfur dioxide to give 1,6 adduct of sulfur dioxide that can be converted into thiophene 1,1 dioxide as shown. Since thiophene is very unstable and has not been synthesized, so substituted thiophenes are very stable. Here 1,1 dioxide, that is 1,1 dioxide thiophene, is very stable. Coming to the synthesis, that is hexatriene, on reaction with sulfur dioxide we get an 1,1 dioxide, which on bromination we get brominated across double bond, and on base, using base, we get 2 HBRs have been released to form an thiophene. Reactions of thiophene, that is thiophene on warming we get an adduct, whereas thiophene on pyrolysis we get tetramethyl thalonitrile. This is a reaction. Highly substituted thiophene on warming we get an adduct, whereas on pyrolysis we get an highly substituted benzene, that is tetramethyl thalonitrile. Coming to the next heterocyclic compound, azepine. The azepine system occurs in 4 tautomeric forms, that is 1H, 2H, 3H and 4H azepines. This is the structure of an azepine. The 1H and 3H systems are the most important one. This is the 1H system, this is 2H system. As you can see, the hydrogen is shifted to the second position. And this is 3H system, where H is shifted to the third position. In this, the H is shifted to the fourth one. Hence, it is called 1H, 2H, 3H and 4H azepines. Whereas in this 4, 1H and 3H are the most important one and stable. Very few 1H azepines are known. The parent compound 1H azepine is an unstable red oil even at low temperature and rearranges to form more stable 3H azepine in the presence of acid or base. The benzo derivatives have been predicted to be more stable provided that annihilation doesn't disturb the aromaticity of benzene ring. Coming to the synthesis of azepine, azepine through valence bond isomerization. This reaction involves a reorganization of the sigma and pi electrons and doesn't involve a migration of any atom. A relevant example is the preparation of N-ethoxycarbonyl 1H azepine from benzene and ethoxycarbonyl nitrene. This is an ethoxycarbonyl nitrene. On photolysis, we get an nitrene molecule. This is an azo compound, and photolysis we get a nitrene with the evolution of nitrogen gas. This nitrene on reaction with benzene we get a cyclic product. This on rearrangement we get an N-ethoxycarbonyl 1H azepine, that is N ethoxycarbonyl 1H azepine. This on base hydrolysis we get acid, that is ester is converted to an acid. This on heating, CO2 is eliminated, that is this step is decarboxylation, we get an 1H azepine. Since 1H azepine is less stable, this is isomerized to a more stable 3H azepine. Coming to the next one, from azerines. An azerine reacts with cyclopentadienones to give 3H azepines. This is cyclopentadienones. On reaction with azerine, and subsequent rearrangement of atoms, and on heating, carbon monoxide is eliminated. With careful acidification, we get an 3H azepines. Next, from phenyl azide. A phenyl azide reacts with primary or secondary amine to give benzazirine, which further undergoes ring expansion to give 3H azerine further. That is, phenyl azide on heating, nitrogen is evolved, the formation of nitrene. This undergoes cyclization to form a three-membered ring, that is benzazirine. This benzazirine on reaction with a diethyl amine to form an attack, which on rearrangement, that is sigma bond rearrangement, we get an seven-membered heterocycle with substituted diethyl amine. This on rearrangement, since 1H azepine is very unstable, this on rearrangement, we get a 3H azepine. Coming to the reactions of azepine, that is applications. First one, using thermal reaction, azepines on heating undergoes aromatization. That is, on heating, this double bond shifts here to form a three-member ring, and this double bond shifts here, and this shift here to form a benzazirine derivative. Here, this bond and radical free radical mechanism, it breaks, which form a nitrogen with free radicals and carbon with free radicals. This, on losing a proton, we get a benzene substituted amide. Coming to the ring contraction, azepines undergo photo ring contraction to give bicyclic compounds. And you can see, and substituted azepines on photolysis in the presence of methanol, we get an photo ring contracted bicyclic compound, that is 4-membered and 5-membered ring. Coming to the next heterocyclic compound, diazepines. The name itself indicates there are two hetero atoms, and these are the structures of an diazepines. Here 1, 2, 1, 3 and 1, 4 diazepines are the parent compounds. Here you can see this is 1, 2 and 1, 3 and this is 1, 4. It is just the place of the nitrogen. The 1,2 and 1,4 diazepines are of great importance, especially the 1,4 diazepine derivatives. This is, for example, 2,3 dihydro 1,4 diazepine. This is 1,4 benzo diazepine. Let's see one by one. Coming to 1,2 diazepines. This occurs in various tautomeric forms, that is 1H, 3H and 4H 1,2 diazepines. These are 1H, that is the H is present on the first position of nitrogen, hence it is 1H 1,2 diazepines. Here the H is shifted to the third position, hence 3H 1,2 diazepine. Here the hydrogen is shifted to the fourth position, hence 4H 1,2 diazepines. However, 5H 1,2 diazepines exist only as the valence tautomeric 3,4 diazo bicyclo 410 hepta 2,4 diene. That is, this double bond shifts here to form a 3-member ring. This double bond shifts here and this bond shifts here. Coming to the synthesis, 1,7 heterocyclization of diazo penta 2,4 dienes followed by a 1,5 hydrogen shift leads to 3H 1,2 diazepines. That is, negative charge on nitrogen attacks this position, this carbon, with the shift of a double bond, subsequent shift of a double bond to form a 7-member ring, which on losing a proton and subsequent addition accepting a proton, we get an 3H12 diazepine, that is 3H12 diazepine. Coming to the next synthesis, 1,5-diketones react with hydrazine to give 5,6-dihydro-4H12 diazepine, that is 1,5-diketones on reaction with hydrazine, which is a condensation reaction, to form 5,6-dihydro-4H12 diazepine. That is, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, H is on the fourth position and a double bond is missing, hence 5,6-dihydro-4H12 diazepine. Coming to the next synthesis, alpha bromoazines react with malonic esters in the presence of a base to give 5,6-dihydro-4H12 diazepine. That is alpha bromoazines. This is alpha bromoazines on reaction with malonic ester in the presence of a base, that is sodium ethoxide. This sodium ethoxide abstracts a proton here to form C minus. This attacks here with the elimination of bromide ion. One more sodium ethoxide is used to abstract one more hydrogen to form a C minus, which attacks this carbon with the elimination of bromide ion to form 5,6-dihydro-4H12 diazepine. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, double bond is missing here, hence 5,6-dihydro-4H12 diazepine. Chemical properties, that is reactions of diazepines. The most characteristic feature of the chemistry of 1,2-diazepines is their facility of ring transformation reactions under thermal as well as photochemical conditions. Under photochemically induced conditions, this diazepines undergoes photochemical reactions to form a 4-membered and 5-membered ring, as well as it's just a shifting of a double bond. Here this is 1, 2, 3, 4H12 diazepine to give this one, and 3H, that is 1, 2, 3, 3H12 diazepine on photolysis to give this product. Thermally induced reactions. 1,2-diazepines undergo electrocyclization on heating to give the diazo norcarediene, followed either by ring opening to give pyridinium N-amides, or by a walk rearrangement and ring opening to give the 1,3-diazepines. That is 1,2-1-acyl-diazepines on heating we get an diazo norcarediene. This on ring opening we get an pyridinium N-amide, or by a walk rearrangement we get an 1,3-diazepines. This is 1,3, that is the positions of nitrogens are at 1 and 3. Here A is generally referred as an acyl group. It may be an ester, it may be a ketone group, it may be an aldehyde. And you can see there are two mechanisms. If the mechanism goes by the red arrows, you can get an pyridinium N-amide. If it goes by the mechanism through black arrows, you will get an walk rearrangement. Coming to the next heterocycle, 1,3-diazepines. Synthetic roots, the halocarbene adduct of 1,3-disubstituted uracil reacts with alcohol and undergo ring expansion to give 1,3-diazepine. That is halocarbon attacks of 1,3 substituted uracil. This is the 1,3 substituted uracil on reaction with alcohol, we get an 1,3 diazepine, that is 1 and 3 diazepine. Reactions of 1,3 diazepine. This compound and reaction with N-phenylselenylthalamide, that is, it is a selenating agent which selenates at the 5th position. This on losing a selenium with the formation of double bond. This is the application of an 1,3 diazepine. 1,3 diazepines react with acid to give 1 carbamyl pyrose. And you can see that ring contraction has happened in this reaction, where 1,3 diazepines react with acid to form an NH2 plus. This on ring contraction we get an 5-membered heterocyclic ring. Coming to the next heterocyclic compound, 1,4 diazepines. It can be synthesized to various routes, that is 2,3 dihydro 1,4 diazepines are formed from ethylene diamine and beta diketones by acid catalyzed cyclocondensation. This is ethylene diamine on reaction with beta ketones through by acid catalyzed cyclocondensation, we get 1,4,2,3 dihydro diazepines. And it can also be prepared by a thermal cope rearrangement, that is base anilines of 1,2 diaminocyclopropanes undergo a thermal cope rearrangement followed by hydrogen, this is an hydrogen migration to give the 2,3 dihalide hydro diazepines. Reactions of 1,4 diazepine, electrophilic substitution reaction. 2,3 dihydro 1,4 diazepines are strongly basic and are readily protonated to give the cation, whose estimated resonance stabilization energy is high at approximately 80 kilojoules per mole. That is, a lone pair on nitrogen shifts to form a double bond, and this double bond shifts here, and this double bond which accepts a proton from an acid, and subsequent rearrangement which neutralizes the positive charge on the nitrogen, and hence we get a quasi racemate, because the hydrogens which are shifting throughout this compound through this place through to all these two nitrogens, hence it is called a quasi racemate. Because of this high degree of resonance stabilization of a cation, A have quasi aromatic properties, and their most characteristic reaction is electrophilic substitution at 6th position. That is, a lone pair on nitrogen shifts to form a double bond, this double bond which takes up an electrophilic compound. This is a 6th position, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. This is a most characteristic reaction. And you can see again the positive charge and has been distributed on these two nitrogens. Hence it is a quasi aromatic property. Here they can be, that is, this can be deuterated, halogenated, nitrated and coupled with triazolium salts under conditions similar to those used for benzene. That is, here electrophile can be deuterium, halogens or nitro groups. Nucleophilic substitution reaction. 6-bromo 2,3 dihydro 1,4 diazepine reacts with alkoxide to give 6 alkoxy derivatives. It is a simple nucleophilic addition reaction. that is alkoxide ion attacks this carbon with the elimination of bromide. Coming to the next heterocycle, thiazepines. This is the structure of thiazepines, which have a three forms, that is 1,2,1,3 and 1,4, which is the positions of sulfur and nitrogen. Let's see 1,2-thiazepines. Coming to the synthetic methods, 5-aminopentane sulfonyl chloride undergoes cyclization on heating to give 1,2-thiazepine-11-dioxide. That is, it's a simple reaction. The lone pair on nitrogen attacks the sulfonyl chloride with the elimination of chloride to form a 7-member heterocycle, which is a 1,2-thiazepine, that is 1,2-thiazepine-11-dioxide. The following ketone reacts with, that is, it is a Michael acceptor, Michael double acceptor, reacts with amines to give 1,2-thiazepine-5-ON. That is, this ketone on reaction with an aromatic amine to form this compound. This on, that is, lone pair on nitrogen attacks this triple bond to form a 7-member ring with a reaction with the treatment of acid. 1,3-thiazepines. Coming to the synthetic methods, 4-bromobutyl isothiocyanate reacts with amines to give 2-amino-1,3-thiazepines. This is an isothiocyanate group. This on reaction with an amine, we get a 7-membered heterocycle, which is a 1,3-thiazepines. Vinyl aziridine reacts with phenyl isothiocyanate to give 1,3-thiazepine. This is a vinyl aziridine reaction with an isothiocyanate, that is an aromatic isothiocyanate, to give an 1,3-thiazepine. Coming to the 1,4-thiazepines, synthetic methods, bromopropylamine reacts with thioglycolic acid to give 1,4-thiazepines. This is a 3-bromopropylamine reacts with thioglycolic acid, which is an analogous of hydroxyglycolic acid, or else glycolic acid, we get an 1,4-thiazepines. Coming to the next one, 2-aminoethanethiol reacts with alpha beta unsaturated ketones to give 1,4-thiazepines. This is a simple condensation step, we get an 1,4-thiazepines. Reactions of 1,4-thiazepine. Chlorination of thioethers generally takes place at the alpha position. That is, this 1,4-thiazepine on reaction with sulfural chloride. Sulfural chloride is employed to chlorinate at the alpha position. This is the alpha position. This on losing a proton with the elimination of chloride ion under heating conditions, we get an 1,4-thiazepines. Coming to the 8-membered heterocycles, in that first one is an adenosine. 8-membered heterocycles are an analogous of an cyclooctet tetraene. Here, this is the structure of an adenosine. Adenosine is an analog of cyclooctatetraene. Adenosine is thermally labile and is likely to be an heterotrophic 4-8-pi system comparable to cyclooctatetraene. Coming to the synthetic methods, cyclobutene undergoes Diels-Alder reaction with triazine to give adenosine and methyl phthalate. That is, there is a cyclobutane ring which undergoes a 4+2 Diels-Alder reaction. We get this adduct. This on rearrangement of sigma and pi bonds, we get an azoxyne. This is an azoxyne and methyl phthalate. The synthesis of azoxyne involves addition of chlorosulfonyl isocyanate to a cyclohexadiene, conversion to the imidate, and introduction of another double bond by allylic bromination and dehydroalogenation. This is a cyclohexadiene on reaction with chlorosulfonyl isocyanate. This is an isocyanate moiety which reacts to form an amide, that is chlorosulfonyl substituted amide. This on reaction with an aromatic thiol, that is lone pair on sulfur, attacks this sulfur with the bond breaking between N and sulfur with the subsequent abstraction of the proton from the acid to form an amide bond. That is, the lone pair on nitrogen shifts to form a double bond, and the double bond, the CO bond, which abstracts a methyl group from the trimethyl tetrafluoroborate to give an imidate. This is an methyl imidate. This methyl imidate on reaction with NBS. NBS is generally used for the allylic bromination. That is, it gets brominated in this position. Since the double bond is here, this is the allylic position, hence it gets brominated here. And on using tertiary potassium butoxide, we get an methoxy substituted azoxyne. Coming to the reactions of azoxyne, methoxy azoxyne undergoes Diels-Alder reaction with N-phenyl triazolein dione to give the adduct. Here, this methoxy azoxyne will be in equilibrium with the imidate. This is an methoxy imidate. Here, methoxy imidate, which is a reaction with, undergoes Diels-Alder reaction with N-phenyl triazolein dione. We get this is an adduct. Methoxy azoxyne undergoes demethylation in the presence of HBr to give lactones. That is, HBr, using HBr, this bromide ion attacks this methyl group with a loss of with the formation of a double bond, and this double bond, which takes up a proton from an HBr to form an amide bond, which is a lactone. Methoxy azoxyne undergoes hydrolysis to give benzonitrate and methyl benzoate. This is an imidate, which on loss of proton we get this product. This is an imine. On acid hydrolysis we get an methyl benzoate. An imine on reacting with base, that is tertiary butoxide, we get an benzonitrate. That is, this base abstracts a proton to form a triple bond with the elimination of methoxide ion. Whereas an acid hydrolysis, this double bond breaks here with the formation of an C double bond O and NH3. On protonation, methoxy azoxyne undergoes protonation in the presence of a metal, potassium and mineral acids to give 3,4 and 3,6 and 7,8 dihydroisomers. That is, methoxy azoxyne on reaction with potassium and mineral acids such as sulfuric acid, HCl and HNO3, we get 3 isomers, that is 3,4, 3,6 and 7,8 isomers. That is, you can see at the 3,4 position, double bond is missing, therefore 3,4 dihydro and 3,6 dihydro and 7,8 dihydro isomers. Coming to the next heterocycle, diazoxanes. This is the general structure. This is the structure of an 1,2 diazocene. The chemistry of 1,2 diazocene is not at we know, it is limited. Hence, the chemistry of 1,4 diazocene is studied. Here, 1,4 dihydro, 1,4 diazocene. It is 1,4 and 1,4 diazocene. Coming to the synthetic methods from cis benzene dioxide. This is a cis benzene dioxide. It has a 2 epoxy groups, which on reaction with an sodium azide in the presence of water. This is a nucleophilic substitution reaction. This sodium, this azide comes and attacks here with the formation of an hydroxy group. And one more equivalent of sodium azide attacks here, the formation of OH group. This on reaction with methyl chloride, that is methyl chloride is methane sulfonyl chloride. When this molecule reacts with methyl chloride, it gets methylated. That is, it is a simple reaction where alcohol is protected, and even with the elimination of nitro group, nitrogen as gas, even NH is protected with methyl group. This on base, it is this on reacting a treatment with potassium hydroxide, we get an N minus. This N minus attacks this carbon with the elimination of O minus to form an aziridine ring. Aziridine ring, that is three-membered heterocycle with in a heterocyclic atom N. This on rearrangement we get an 1,4 dimethylated diazocene. This on reaction with potassium in ammonia we get an N minus, that is 2 nitrogen anions. This on hydrolysis we get an 1,4 dihydro 1,4 diazocene. It can also be prepared from cis benzene trioxide. This is similar as at a previous one. We get here 3 azide groups, and instead of methyl chloride, here it is treated with tosyl chloride. Tosyl is a good alcohol protecting group, and it is also used to reduce azide to an amine. And here the lone pairs of nitrogen attacks this carbon with the elimination of all the tosyl compounds, tosyl groups, to form a 3-member heterocycle compound, which is attached to a 6-membered one. This on reaction with an RX, that is here for example methyl chloride, the lone pairs on nitrogen with attacks an R with the elimination of X to form a substituted nitrogen, which on reaction with nitroso tetrafluoroborate we get an N nitroso. This on rearrangement we get an N nitroso is eliminated. On rearrangement we get an azocene. This on reaction with potassium in ammonia we get an N minus, which on subsequent hydrolysis we get azocene. Coming to the next one, dioxazenes. That is here 1,4 dioxazene. Synthetic methods. 4,5 epoxy cyclohexene can be converted to cis benzene oxide, which undergoes valence isomerization to give 1,4 dioxazene. That is 4,5 epoxy cyclohexane on reaction with NBS. As I told before, NBS is used for the allylic bromination. This is the allylic bromination. We get an 2 isomers. The first isomer is treated with an peracetyl, that is trifluoro peracetyl, peracetic acid. We get an bromoazocene, for the other isomer on reaction with a sulfuric acid we get a diepoxide, which on reaction with KOH in bromine, we get this compound. This on rearrangement, we get an bromo substituted azoxystrobin. This on reaction with tributyl tin hydride, we get bromine is eliminated and azoxystrobin is formed. This is a very good reaction because both isomers can be converted to an azoxystrobin. So no side products here. Coming to the diethiazines, that is 1,4-diethiazine. Synthetic methods, 2,5-diethiobicyclo-4,20-octadiene undergoes ring opening on heating to give 1,4-diethiazine. And you can see a ring opening reaction to form an 1,4-diethiazine. Diethiothiazole can be converted to 6-acetoxydiethiazine. And this is an diethiothiazole. If it is a OH here, it is called diethiothiazole, TOL. Since it is an acetyl group here, hence AL. This on reaction with ethylene dichloride, we get this compound, that is a formation of an 8-member ring. This on acidification, we get a diol. Diol on reaction with tosyl chloride, as I said before, tosyl chloride is a good alcohol protecting group. Hence, it is protected with a tosylide. This on reaction with tertiary butoxide, which abstracts a proton here to form a double bond with the subsequent elimination of a tosylide. This on acid hydrolysis, we get an hydroxy group. This on oxidation, we get a ketone. This on reaction with acetyl chloride, we get acetyl, that is acetyl substituted diethiazine. Here, this step can't be skipped just because during acetylation, this step is very important just because double bond is formed on reaction with acetyl chloride, whereas here double bond can't be expected when it is acetylated. Hence, it is oxidized to ketone and then it is treated with acetyl chloride to form an diethiazine. Coming to the next one, 1,2-dichloro-3,3,4,4-tetrafluorocyclobutene reacts with sulfur chloride in the presence of butyl lithium to give perfluorinated tetracyclic 1,4-diethiazine. It is here, this is a cyclobutene. 3 molecules of cyclobutene reacts with 2 molecules of sulfur chloride in the presence of N-butyl lithium. We get an tetracyclic 1,4-diethiazine. Yeah, this is all about 6 and 7 member heterocycles. In the coming classes, I'll be teaching about heterocyclic chemistry part 2. In this, I'll be discussing heterocycles containing phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, and bismuth. Thank you, guys.